Hey, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will go over the basic definitions and characteristics of triangles and quadrilaterals. Let's get started. A triangle is a shape with three sides and three angles. We can name our angles angle BAC, angle ABC, and angle ACB. And it is made up of three line segments, which we can name AB, BC, and AC. Where the line segments intersect is called a vertex. We can name the vertices by the points, point A, point B, and point C. Remember that we can classify triangles by their angles, like a right triangle, where one angle is 90 degrees, or an acute triangle, where every angle is less than 90 degrees, or an obtuse triangle, where one angle is larger than 90 degrees. But we can also classify triangles by their sides. An equilateral triangle has side lengths that are all the same. A scalene triangle has no equal side lengths, and an isosceles triangle has two equal side lengths. But regardless of what type of triangle we're working with, one thing is always true. They have the same sum of their interior angles. Interior angles are the angles that are made at the vertices. In a triangle, when we add all of these angles together, the sum is 180 degrees. For example, in an equilateral triangle, all of the angles are the same. And if we add them all up, we get 60 plus 60 plus 60, which is the same as 60 times 3, which is 180 degrees. So here I have a triangle with two given angles and one mystery angle. How will I find the degrees of my mystery angle? Well, I know that my interior angles are all going to add up to 180 degrees. So I can say 180 degrees is equal to my mystery angle plus 70 degrees plus 70 degrees. And now I just need to solve this equation for x. So first I'm going to add my known angles. 70 plus 70, that's going to give me 140 degrees. So now I have 180 degrees is equal to my mystery degrees plus 140 degrees. So if I solve this for x, I'm going to subtract 140 degrees from this side, that gives me 0, and 140 degrees from this side, which gives me 0 and 4 and 0, 40 degrees. So my mystery degree is 40 degrees. A quadrilateral is a shape with four sides and four angles. A quadrilateral has four angles named ACD, BAC, CDB, and DBA. A quadrilateral has four sides made up by line segments that we can name using the endpoints. AB, AC, BD, and CD. Where the line segments intersect is called the vertex. We name the vertices as points A, B, C, and D. There are many different types of quadrilaterals, but they all have four sides and four angles. When you look at this square, what do you notice about line segments A, B, and CD? Well, there are two things. One, they are parallel line segments. They are equidistant apart and will never cross each other. And two, since you know this is a square, that means that my side lengths are the exact same. That means that line segments AB and CD are congruent. Congruent is a very important word in geometry. It means two things that are exactly the same shape and size. This parallelogram also has the opposite sides that are congruent. Line segments A, B, and C, D are exactly the same shape and size. here are 5 quadrilaterals. Looking at these shapes, which ones have 2 sets or 2 pairs of parallel sides? Which ones have 4 congruent sides? Remember, congruent means line segments that are exact same shape and size. Which ones have 2 sets of congruent sides? Which ones have 1 set of congruent sides? While these shapes may all look different, they all have a few things in common. 4 sides, 4 angles, and the same interior angle sum. We will use a square to calculate the interior angle for all quadrilaterals. Remember, a square has 4 right angles. Do you remember the degrees of a right angle? Yeah, it's 90 degrees. So to find the sum of the interior angles, we would add 90 plus 90 plus 90 plus 90. And this is the same as saying 4 times 90, which is equal to 360 degrees. In this square, we can also draw a diagonal line from one vertex to another vertex that's not next to it. Now we have 2 triangles. Remember, each triangle has a sum of interior angles of 180 degrees. So if we add the interior angles for both triangles together, what do we get? 180 plus 180, which is equal to 360. And we expect that because 360 is the sum of the interior angles of a quadrilateral. So now I have a quadrilateral with 3 given angles and 1 mystery angle. How will I find my mystery angle? Well, I know the sum of all of my interior angles will be 360 degrees. So I can say 360 degrees is equal to my mystery angle plus 105 degrees plus 75 degrees plus 75 degrees. And I need to solve for my mystery angle X. So let's add up the angles that I know. I know 75 plus 75 is 150 degrees, and 150 plus 105 is going to give me 255. So now I have 360 degrees is equal to mystery angle plus 255 degrees. So now if I subtract 255 from either side, I'm going to get, I need to borrow here, 501. I get my mystery angle is equal to 105 degrees. Nice work. Great job studying triangles, quadrilaterals, and their interior angles. You're really getting the hang of geometry now. Study what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.